So, the bullet physics engine always looks like being on the moon. This is like way too slow. But that's actually pretty simple to fix. We have the step simulation method here, and we can just increase the time, which has gone since the last frame. But on the same hand, we need to increase the max sub steps to 2, for example, because otherwise it will do nothing. So if we try this. This looks already way faster, but maybe still a bit too slow. So we can also do this. And I think this looks pretty nice. But I wondered so the third argument is the fixed time step. So if we do this like 3 times, do we actually need 3 times as much CPU? So in the task manager we can actually check that. Kinda looks always the same, like around, I don't know. This might be the core which is actually was used, and this is like 50%. And if we do this now to 1, which is the default. Then it's still kind of the same. I don't see any real difference in the CPU usage. Well, but it was quite nice to play around with these numbers. If we let, for example, 3, and if we decrease this to 20 FPS. Then it looks very different and it even behaves differently. Now it's jittering around. This is not so bad, but now we see a difference in the behavior, like before the whole tower just exploded to all sides, but now just a bit. 40. Now it doesn't even fall over. I think 60 FPS is the best, but just it's just nice to see some different values. What's also possible is to actually just call this like 2 times. I don't know which version is better because, well, I think step simulation is better, like calling it once, because then it can handle the simulation logic maybe a bit better, I don't know. And I think 60 FPS is the best one, so like to prevent the moon physics, just do time 3 and then with 3 max sub steps.